On Tuesday, news broke that Trump was firing Secretary of State Rex Tillerson and replacing him with the current CIA director, Mike Pompeo. I did an extensive report on that scary nomination, which you can watch by clicking right up here. I think that's right. But now I want to talk about Pompeo's potential replacement at the CIA, Gina Haspel, who is the current deputy director of the CIA. But unlike Pompeo, who I think will fly through the nomination process with bipartisan support, Haspel may not. There are bipartisan alarm bells sounding about her tenure as one of the most pro-torture CIA officials ever. She was one of the originators of the waterboarding torture regime under Bush. And while Obama banned torture with an executive order in 2009, which was kind of weak, Trump has expressed an eagerness to bring it back, despite it being against United States and international law. To preface what I'm about to say, I will call her a war criminal throughout this video, as the ACLU has done many times, and I don't do that lightly. She's committed war crimes. She's a scary individual. And here's a bit of Gina Haspel's background. Just over a year after the September 11th attacks, the CIA dispatched the veteran clandestine officer Gina Haspel to oversee a secret prison in Thailand. Shortly after, agency contractors in the frantic hunt for the conspirators waterboarded a Qaeda suspect three times and subjected him to brutal interrogation techniques. Let's stop there for a second. Haspel was in charge of this secret prison called a black site in Thailand. It was off the books. That black site was one of the most notorious waterboarding torture sites during this dark era in the Bush administration. That's an immediate disqualification in my book, but not to the Trump administration. There's of course more. Ms. Haspel was also embroiled in another dark episode in the CIA's interrogation program. In 2005, Jose Rodriguez, then the head of the agency's clandestine service, ordered the destruction of videotapes of the waterboarding sessions. Ms. Haspel, serving as Mr. Rodriguez's chief of staff, was a strong advocate for getting rid of the tapes, former CIA officials said. Years later, when the CIA wanted to name Ms. Haspel to run clandestine operations, Senator Dianne Feinstein blocked the promotion over Ms. Haspel's role in the interrogation program and the destruction of the tapes. Good on Dianne Feinstein, who can be a bit hawkish, for her role in this investigation and her blocking of that promotion. So Haspel ordered a destruction of tapes, tapes that incriminated herself. No wonder Trump likes her. But do you see how people in power are treated differently? If that were a low-level employee, even at the CIA, they would be in prison. But she can torture, she can destroy evidence, and then be nominated to be the head of the CIA. But before I get into the details of the torture she played a direct role in, let's take a look at the senators who have already come out against her nomination, and there have been a few. Elizabeth Warren tweeted this: "Torture doesn't just violate our values, it jeopardizes our national security and puts our military at risk. Gina Haspel's involvement in the US's discredited torture program makes her unfit to lead the CIA. I stand with Rand Paul, Ron Wyden, and other senators against her nomination." John McCain has also tweeted out opposition, obviously a victim of torture himself, has long spoken out about this issue. And speaking of Rand Paul, here's Rand Paul breaking down why he's against the nomination of Gina Haspel. The Fox News anchor opened with asking Senator Paul why he's going against the dear President Trump on his appointments of Pompeo and Haspel. And here is how Senator Paul responds and some of that exchange.
You know, I'm a big supporter of President Trump. One of the things I really liked about him as a candidate was his vocal opposition to the Iraq war, the idea that regime change in Iraq actually led to unintended consequences. It made Iran stronger and tipped the balance of power in the Middle East. He's appointing people around him who actually still think the Iraq war was a good idea and actually think that we should have a new war with Iran. Specifically on the CIA director, I oppose her because she believes that waterboarding should be something that we use. And I think America shouldn't be known for torture. And I have members of my family in the military. I don't want, if they're ever captured, for foreign countries to think torture is okay.
And let me step in there. You say she believes, Gina Haspel believes in this. She was working in a capacity at the CIA where everybody was taking orders. So Gina Haspel, you're saying, how do you know what she believes?
Well, there was a book written about the torture treatment, the waterboarding, and some of her comments were basically gleeful. The man can't breathe and he's choking on saliva and water, and she's saying, oh, you're a good actor, and it's you know, I can't believe a grown man's crying because of this treatment. And it almost seemed to be a bit of glee in her voice that she actually enjoyed the torture. And I think that's not who we need to lead the CIA. There are many career officials at the CIA who would be perfectly competent to do this, but we should not reward somebody who actually participated in torture treatment. Remember, they went to Thailand to do this because it's illegal in the United States.
Well, there were black sites that were set up. I mean, we've learned so much about that. So I want to press in a little bit, though.
They went to Thailand because it's illegal to do here. They also didn't present the prisoners to the Red Cross. They flew them around the world and secreted them in Thailand, which is against everything we say we're for. The Geneva Convention is supposed to be something about being humane to prisoners. This is the wrong kind of message to send the world by putting this woman.
Running counter to the president today, I want to bring you back. I appreciate you on both topics, including the breaking news.
Notice how the Fox News anchor quickly cuts him off after her follow-up question to him was, well, how do you know she supports torture? Well, if you did an ounce of research, a Google search, or really cared about anything except spouting your own propaganda, you would have seen everything that I said earlier pretty quickly. And these details too. Abu Zubaydah was one of the prisoners that was tortured at the site that Haspel oversaw because they thought he was Osama bin Laden's number three or number four guy, a top guy in Al-Qaeda. They were wrong. They were fucking wrong. And they did this to him. As the CIA's video cameras rolled, security guards shackled Abu Zubaydah to a gurney and interrogators poured water over his mouth and nose until he began to suffocate. They slammed him against a wall, confined him for hours in a coffin-like box, and deprived him of sleep. The 31-year-old Zubaydah begged for mercy, saying that he knew nothing about the terror group's future plans. The CIA official in charge, known as in agency lingo as the chief of base, mocked his complaints, accusing Zubaydah of faking symptoms of psychological breakdown. The torture continued. That chief of base was Gina Haspel. Under her direction, he was waterboarded 83 times, nearly drowning to death multiple times. They'd assault him. They would strip him naked and stuff him in tiny boxes, like that ProPublica article said. He lost his left eye. One declassified cable among scores obtained by the American Civil Liberties Union in a lawsuit against the architects of the enhanced interrogation techniques says that chief of base and another senior counterterrorism official on scene had the sole authority power to halt the questioning. Haspel never did so, records show, watching as Zubaydah vomited, passed out, and urinated on himself while shackled. During one waterboarding session, Zubaydah lost consciousness and bubbles began gurgling from his mouth. At one point, Haspel spoke directly with Zubaydah, accusing him of faking symptoms of psychological distress and psychological breakdown. In a scene described in a book written by one of the interrogators, the chief of base, Haspel, came to his cell and congratulated him on the fine quality of his acting. According to the book, the chief of base, who was identified only by title, said, "Good job. I like the way you're drooling. It adds realism. I'm almost buying it. You wouldn't think a grown man would do that." Emasculating him, mocking him, enjoying it, enjoying the torture of a man. And let's strip away the pretense. This is torture. This is not enhanced interrogation. Zubaydah was vomiting, urinating on himself, foaming at the mouth, unconscious, and she mocked him for it. This is the definition of torture under the Geneva Convention, which means that if she's guilty, and it most certainly looks like she is a war criminal who should be in front of a judge being tried in international court, not in our government. She can't be tried in the United States because God knows we're not going to do anything about it. In fact, she is embraced by our national security establishment, and they're loving her. Even Obama's pick for CIA director, he served as CIA director, John Brennan, went on cable news the other day bragging about this war criminal's extensive experience and background, even though reports say that he was concerned about her and kept her out of major roles in the CIA. She was nicknamed Bloody Gina by her colleagues for her love of torture. So Brennan was concerned about her enough to keep her away from his decision-making in his CIA. But when he's in public and he's not in charge anymore, oh, she has so much experience. And that goes to a huge problem in the CIA and the national security establishment as a whole. They are so insular and protect their own, no matter what their own do. And this goes beyond party. No matter how many war crimes they commit, someone who is known to be a torturer, who enjoys it, who destroyed evidence in an investigation of her, someone who is capable of immense brutality, might lead the CIA, because the CIA protects their own, and they didn't dispel her from their ranks like they should have. Luckily, there will be some pushback from the Senate, as I alluded to before, a bipartisan group of senators containing liberals and libertarians like Rand Paul seem to be raising the alarm bells, even though the bloodthirsty wing of the Republican Party, which is most of the Republican Party, is outraged by the fact that they're going against this. Republican Representative Liz Cheney of Wyoming accused Senator Rand Paul of sympathizing with terrorists over his opposition. Gina Haspel has spent her career defending the American people and homeland. Rand Paul is defending and sympathizing with terrorists, she tweeted. This is what we've come to in the post 9/11 world. We're still here. We're standing up for basic civil liberties and human rights and standing with international law against torture. And by the way, the Eighth Amendment of the United States Constitution is sympathizing with terrorists, is synonymous with that. This arrogance and love of brutality cannot stand. After Bush left office when I was a teenager, I remember feeling relief that this kind of torture, this kind of absolute evil would be gone from our government. Obviously, I was wrong. And let me add one more thing. Torture does not make us safer, as Rand Paul alluded to. Would we want those tactics being used on our soldiers? Yeah, but empathy is a foreign concept to conservatives.